How to game share and link PS5 accounts with a friend, or basically how to never pay full price for a game again. Guys, you have no idea how hard it was to really put this into words that are simple enough. So no jokes along the way, because I don't want to lose you. We're going to show you how you can link your PS5 accounts, how you can game share with a friend, and you basically will never have to buy a full price game again. Here's how it works. I, Amidou, I buy my PlayStation 5. Yay, I got it, cool. So here's my PS5 system. On my PS5 system, by default, console sharing is enabled. You know it as game sharing, right? I can check that by going into settings, by going into users and accounts, other, and then console sharing and offline play. So now I, on my PS5, can share every game. Every user, every PSN account on my PlayStation 5 can play every game I bought. I buy Black Ops with my money on my PS5, and I want to play with my PSN account, Amazing Amidou. Easy. My brother, my little brother, also wants to play Black Ops. He's 10 years old, but he's a badass, so I let him play. But I don't want him to play on my PSN account because he sucks ass. So he plays on his Amidou's shitty brother PSN account on my PS5, and that is possible because the console sharing is set to enabled. Now, my broke-ass friend and colleague and your Games Radar host, Danny, also wants to play Black Ops. He spent all his money on his PlayStation 5, so he can't afford the game. Remember, I have the game. So then he calls me and says, yo, Amidou, I really need that Black Ops search, right? That's how he talks. I really need that. I'm a good guy, so I help him out. So what we do is, on the phone, I tell him, Danny, you already have your own PSN account on your PlayStation 5, dumbass Danny. Now you can also enter my PSN account data, Amazing Amidou, and log my PSN account on your PS5. He does that, right? Over the phone, I give him my email, my password. Now my PSN account is on Danny's PS5. He goes into the account and enables console sharing. Again, you do this with the same steps. You go into settings, you go to users and accounts, and then other, and there you select console sharing and offline play. Now it's enabled on Danny's PS5. He goes into the library on my PSN account, downloads the game, and now he has Black Ops on his PS5. He can switch over to Dumbass Danny, and now he can play Black Ops on his PS5 with his PSN account, right? Simple as that. He can play Black Ops as Dumbass Danny, and he can also play with me, against me, as Amazing Amidou, me playing on my PS5. You got me. It's simple. The problem is, the only caveat to this is, that while Danny can now play Black Ops because console sharing is enabled through my account on his PS5, my little brother on my PlayStation 5 can no longer play Black Ops because the system sharing is not enabled on my PS5 anymore, right? So if I want my brother to be able to play again, I, on my PlayStation 5, go into my account, enable console sharing, and now my brother can play again on his, I mean, his dumbass brother account. But Danny can't play anymore, dumbass Danny, you know? You get me? So Danny and my brother, they will never be able to play Black Ops together, but I, who bought the game as Amazing Amidou, can always play the game on my PSN account. It's that simple. So you follow these steps and you and a friend can share every fucking game you want, and you will never have to pay full price again. And your family members, you know, just keep that in mind. They are the little brother in my example. If you got any questions, comment them. Subscribe. Love you guys. Bye-bye. See you tomorrow for more news.